Namaste, welcome to Geeta's Kitchen. Today we'll see how to make a very tasty snack from the north, and that is kachori. For the kachori we need two things. One is the outer covering and the inner filling. Inner filling we are going to make with urad dal or black gram, urad dal kachori. And the first we'll make the dough for the outer covering. For that I have taken 2 cups of wheat flour or atta. To this add 1/2 cup of maida or plain flour. Add some salt to taste. Mix it all together. Want lovely crispy kachoris, so take 1/4 teaspoon of baking powder and add to this. Again mix it well. Next you need to add some oil. See, till the dough becomes like breadcrumbs. When you mix it, you should be able to hold it in your palm. I will just show you now. Just rub the dough with your fingers. It should become like breadcrumbs. See, when you hold it like this, see now it is breaking, but it should hold. Add a little more oil if required. You can use either oil or ghee or a mixture of oil and ghee, that is left to you. You will need about 3 to 4 tablespoons of oil, and you can see it should. Next, add in water a little at a time and make a smooth dough. Our dough is ready. We'll cover this and keep it aside. Now for the filling, 1/2 cup of urad dal and soaked it overnight and kept. Now drain the water completely and we'll grind it to a slightly coarse paste. Sprinkle just 1 or 2 tablespoons of water. Don't add more water while grinding. We have ground the urad dal to a paste, adding very little water, and it is slightly coarse. Next, heat 2 tablespoons of oil in a pan. Keep the flame low and add a teaspoon of chilli powder. And then about 3 teaspoons of dania powder, that is coriander seeds powder, and this is somph which I have coarsely powdered, about 1 teaspoon of that, a little bit of hing, about 1/4 teaspoon, and then add the ground paste to it. Everything well together and continue stirring it till it becomes quite dry. So add some salt to taste. Now it has become little dry. At this stage you can switch it off and allow it to cool. Here I have kept some oil for frying. Take a portion of the dough, roll it out onto your palm, flatten it, and on an oiled board, just press it out. Keep a portion of this filling in it and bring the edges up together like this. Can take out any extra portion of the dough.
press it back and again roll it out. It should not be too thin or too thick also. Roll it out to a medium thickness. To test the oil, put a small piece of dough. It should slowly rise to the surface and come up. That means it is ready. Okay, just remove this. And you have to fry these kachoris over a low to medium heat. Don't fry it on a high heat. Over a low to medium heat, you fry them. And lightly press it so that it puffs up also. Fry it over a low to medium heat till it puffs up. And also you get a nice golden brown color to it. So you need to have patience to fry kachoris. Only then you will get a typical what we call as a khasta kachori. Meaning it should be flaky and crispy. So likewise we can fry the other kachoris too. Depending on the size of your container, you can put one or two kachoris at a time. So while one batch is frying in the oil, you can keep rolling out the other kachoris and keeping ready side by side. Turn them over. While it is frying, just spray the oil over it like this so that it also puffs up well and is well cooked. See, now we have completed frying all our kachoris and kept ready. You can serve this just with green chutney and sweet chutney also. But today I'll show you the traditional side dish, the alu sabji, which is served with this green chutney. Especially when you travel by train and you go from say Chennai or anywhere in the south upwards to North India. In the stations, you will find this kachori and aloo sabji being served, and it's very popular in the cities too. Allahabad, Kanpur, whenever I visited these places, I have had this. So for that, I have taken two large potatoes, peeled them, and I am just going to chop them like this. I have also chopped some ginger and green chillies and kept ready. Taken 2 tablespoons of oil in a pressure cooker, allowed it to heat. Now to this, add 1 teaspoon of jeera or cumin seeds. Add a little bit of hing, and then this is the chopped ginger, chopped green chillies. Also add in the chopped potatoes, peeled and chopped. To this, add some turmeric powder, salt to taste, and dania powder. About 2 teaspoons. Mix everything well together for a few minutes. The vegetable is well coated with the masalas and it is all stir fry. Next add water to the pressure cooker. I'll add about 2 cups of water. Close it and cook it for 2 whistles. See, now the pressure has released. Let's open the cooker and check our alu ki sabji. It has cooked very well. I have transferred the sabji into my serving bowl. Now squeeze the juice of a lemon into it. Finally, top it with some freshly chopped coriander leaves and your aloo sabji is done. So when you want to serve, take two kachoris in a plate like this and serve it along with this aloo ki sabji. As I said, you can also just serve it with green chutney and sweet chutney. But this is the traditional method of serving kachori and aloo sabji. Do try out this recipe, share it with your family and friends, and please come back to Geeta's Kitchen for more such easy, tasty recipes. And don't forget to tap the bell icon for notification about my latest videos. Thank you.